Hey, Alan fans, a different sort of video today. I haven't done one of these for ages. It's been live streams because it's more fun. But I thought I'd do a quick video talking about this guitar and all guitars in some way. This is the recently acquired Fender Mexican limited edition Telecaster with a roasted maple neck and custom shop 51 Nocaster pickups. Lovely, lovely guitar. Pretty good value for money. Enjoyed playing it. It was good. We had fun on the live stream, and I'll be using this for years to come. But it's got problems. It's not perfect, which anyone who's trying to sell you an instrument, which is most people that are popular on YouTube, won't tell you these sort of things. But this applies to lots and lots of guitars, certainly ones that aren't like handmade. So production guitars, import guitars, things that are under £1,000, maybe above as well, depending on where you get them from. So here's the problem. The problem on this one was the strings. I can't play it anymore. Strings, G-string is bust. And the reason is that when these strings are put on these guitars, they're put on without care and attention, because time's of the essence. You know, this is someone in the factory. They've got their process nailed down. They just whip through it every time, and they get the job done, which is fine. But then these strings that are put on without much care and attention will sit on here for maybe months. They've never been stretched in or played properly. They might well have been intonated, and you know, the setup might have been checked, but they haven't been, you know, run through the mill of big bends and an hour's jamming, or you know, a couple hours live stream or something. So what I noticed, the tuning stability wasn't great. So I thought, well, I'll give them all a bit of a pull, you know, a bit of a stretch. And I pulled the E string and it dropped like two tones, so there was slack in there somewhere. When I pulled the G string, it just snapped. And that's the case. It's not a case of the quality of the strings, you know, whether the Dario's or some cheap brand or anything like that. But when you get a new guitar, if it's been imported, if it's been in a warehouse for a while, you just don't know. The strings really aren't worth playing. Just get them off and change them. So I got some Elixirs, 9-42. I might go up to the 10 gauge, but I'm going to stick with 9s for now. Keep traditional Telecaster territory. So that's one issue. Issue number two on this guitar is the string tree. If you look at the string tree, for those who don't know, because I know you're not all sort of gearheads, is this bit here. And what it does, it just pulls down on these last two strings to give them a bit more of a break angle over the nut, you see. So they're sort of being pulled down here. So there's a good friction sort of point there to ring the note out. The problem is that when they put this on, look, it's absolutely decked to the face of the headstock. So again, times of the essence, the guy's come along, he's just got his string tree straight in with the drill, as far as it'll go, and on to the next one. Doesn't need to be that far down. So the other thing is, you can get friction here, because this is just literally it's hard to see on there, but it's just a bent over piece of metal, really. That's all it is. So what I've done is I've ordered some roller string trees, which will sit off the deck a little bit. You'll see this better once I've put it on. They're kind of hard to see on this camera. It doesn't focus very well. But the difference with those is there's two little rollers on the ends, and the strings go underneath the roller, which means there's no friction at that point, so they're free to sort of move, and should improve tuning stability a bit. So that's one issue that will be solved. The other one, which isn't really an issue, but I wanted to do it anyway. When you get import stuff, you never quite know what things are made of, and this bridge is made of probably chromed pot metal. It could be steel, or it could be some other sort of alloy that's less dense, you know, lighter materials, cheaper materials, essentially, is what we're saying here. So to that end, I've gone out and bought these. It's easier if I show you a picture. Those, they are brass saddles. So there's one there. So I've got six of them. So they're going to replace the sort of pot metal, whatever they are, chrome saddles that I've currently got on here. And now, does that make a difference? Yes, aesthetically, it'll look cool. It should make a difference to the tone. Certainly, if you ask almost all luthiers, they'll say yes, it'll make a difference, because it's a contact point for the string here. I'm not worried about this square bit of metal, that's fine. But it's this contact point for the string. You know, they're vibrating and producing friction at that point. And the dense of the material here, you know, it's going to restrict it. It should make a difference. Now, I'm not falling in with the cork sniffing crowd. I'm not going to say I could tell you what the difference is. I'm not going to say it will be better. I'm not even going to say that I could tell the difference, to be honest with you. We won't be able to do a comparison because the strings are already knackered. But they look nice. And for £25, I'm replacing the bridge saddles and the string tree with what's supposed to be superior components. So why not? For that price, if I'm going to have this guitar for a long time, and I like it as much as I do. It may as well be as good as I can get it. So for £25, it seemed a no-brainer. So I'm going to stick all this on, and then we'll return and have a look at it. Here we go. And I'm back. The job's done. Took me a little while. Always a voyage of discovery, these things. A couple of points I thought, oh no, I'm knackered, this isn't going to work. But no, it's all fine. First of all, the string tree is on. Let me see if I can show you that. So now you can see there's quite a chunkier thing up here. But I don't know if you can see, if the camera's not really good at focusing. But there's a little roller there, and it actually goes right through there. So this is now like a frictionless thing. And it's not decked anymore. You see, it's still putting tension over the, pulling it over the nut enough. Don't know if you can see. It's very hard to get good camera angles. Yeah, you can sort of see there. Like that. That's definitely just putting enough downward pressure there. And it goes back up. To be honest, I'm not impressed with the design of this. Look at it. It's quite a boxy, clunky bit of metal. It's not quite what I was expecting. I should have looked at it because it looks exactly like it looks in the picture. But really what I was hoping for was, like I've got on the Strat, I was hoping for one of those sort of style. It's a lot sleeker. You see, it's just like an angled bit and a couple of tiny little rollers rather than this big old chunky thing. So this may be a temporary. I might see if I can get one of the more sleekish looking ones. It wasn't quite what I was expecting that, but that's okay. It does the job and it works. Here's the cool bit is the brass saddles. Look at those now. Man, that's nice, isn't it? Here's an interesting thing. I mean, that looks a bit weird, but that is correctly intonated with the E string all the way back here, which just kind of really, again, shows that if you compare it to what it was like, it hadn't been intonated at all at the factory. It hadn't been set up at all, really. So it was important to do that. So as well as changing the saddles for brass, I've intonated the guitar because that bottom E was well off. And I mean, here's a sound. I don't have lamb cam set up, unfortunately. That's the neck pickup, middle position. And then that glorious neck Telecaster position. So there we go. A video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you've got any questions, put them in the comments. If not, I'll probably catch you on the live stream on Monday. So there you go. A couple of little cheap improvements to make to a Telecaster if you've got one. And by the way, here are all the old bridge parts. And the one point where I thought I might be knackered was these actually turn out to be a lot longer than the ones that were supplied. But the ones that were supplied had longer screws, so it was sort of evened out. But I can just tell you now that even though that's probably about 30, maybe 20% bigger than the brass saddles side by side, I'll sort of show you there. You see the size difference. See what I mean? So even though that's sort of maybe 10, 15, 20% bigger, it weighs less than the brass. So the brass is the way to go, I think. Anyway, thank you very much. Peace. Lamb out.